This conference will now be recorded.
Hi and hello everyone. Welcome to Isha Training Solutions. I hope I am audible to everyone. Please acknowledge me that you are able to hear my voice properly. And I hope my screen is visible to everyone also. Those who are facing any problem, please let me know.
You are audible.
Thank you, Manoj. Hello all. I am Saravanan Srinivasan. I'm going to take you through the entire journey of AppDynamics APM tool. So I have close to 11 years of experience in this field. You know, tools like Dynatrace, AppDynamics, Neuralink, LoadRunner, JMeter, NeoLoad, Performance Center, all those tools. And I have wide range of experience in all the protocols. I worked with multiple verticals. So I have quite a bit of experience in this field. So we are going to learn AppDynamics for the next 3 weeks, basically. So I'm going to tell you what is the benefit that we are going to get out of this APM tool, AppDynamics APM tool. What are all the key things that we are going to learn as part of the learning? And you guys can ask me questions like whatever you guys are expecting to get out of this training session, because I always encourage people to ask questions, ask your requirements, basically, because it is all learning. It is all collective learning. We are going to learn, right? So you tell me, like, what is your expectation? What for we are coming here for the training institute? So we'll try to fulfill all your requirements, basically. So I'm going to show you the content, basically, what we are going to learn as part of the AppDynamics session. And you guys can put forth all your questions so that it will be kind of a healthy discussion. It should not be a monologue session. It should be a dialogue session. Everybody I'm encouraging everybody to ask questions, because you are here to learn something. Don't assume anything. Always ask your question, get the question clarified, so that your fundamental will be always strong. Because that is what the real motto, right? Like, wherever we go, whatever we do, our fundamental should be strong. We should not assume anything. We should learn thoroughly. So you always welcome to ask question. So in that way, we start our demo session. So basically, this is the course content we are going to learn for the next 3 weeks for AppDynamics session. So these are the key topics that we are going to learn, because now the industry is moving towards APM tools, application performance monitoring or application performance management tools. Okay, very famous tools are there in the industry, say like AppDynamics, Dynatrace, Neuralink, CAAPM, even Pinpoint. All these tools are available in the industry, but very few tools are leading in the market. The market share is very, very high. In that, AppDynamics tool is one of the tool, one of the key tool. We have a lot of openings are there for AppDynamics tool. You can work as an AppDynamics admin. You can be a performance tester who is having a value-add understanding of this APM tool. Even the developer can use this tool when they are doing their unit testing. Whenever they are using for their unit testing activity, they can use it. Even the infrastructure monitoring team can use this, because predominantly 24/7 people are working in front of the machine, sitting and watching what is happening to my infrastructure, what is happening to my production servers, what is happening to the CPU utilization, memory utilization, like that. People are day in, day out, they are working, right? For them also, it is really, really a value-add tool, because there are artificial intelligence that is available in this AppDynamics tool, which will help them to do their job little easy. So for them also, it will be really, really helpful. So for the performance tester, you can use it. Developer, you can use it. Infrastructure monitoring team, you can use it. Like that, each and every donor of people can use this tool for their day in day out work. So that is how this course content is also constructed, because everybody should get the benefit of it. Say now, what is happening in the industry? Everything is fast, everything is agile, everything moving towards quick time, right? So like, I don't know, there are people are available in this forum. How many are working in waterfall model till now? Very few people will be working, because the industry trend is moving towards agile. Industry trend is moving towards DevOps. So you need to be fast, quick. Your work should be that rapid enough to find certain things. So what happened traditionally, if there is a production outage, the developer will spend close to 2 hours, 3 hours, even 1 day to identify the issue itself. Okay, but now using these tools, these APM tools, you can quickly identify what is the root cause of that particular production outage. You can straight away do the issue fixing activity. That is how this is really useful. And also for performance testers, what is happening, they will spend like 5 to 10 days for the script preparation, 3 to 5 days for the execution, 1 or 2 days for the report collation, and finally they will say there is an issue. But here, using this APM tool, you can quickly identify the performance issues, and you can report to the stakeholder, developer, and then they can do on issue identification and then fixing of that particular issue. In that way, the entire market trend is moving towards. So it is really, really important for everyone to learn this APM tool. This is a value add information apart from your regular activity that you are doing. I know the performance engineers, there are performance engineers, those who are working, they will use some utility tools like JVisual VM, JControl, JProfiler, URKit, all those tools to identify certain memory related issue, certain CPU related issue, to spend some time to identify these things, right? But using this APM tool, in a single stretch, you can identify all the things: CPU related, memory related, database related, application server related, browser related, like that. Each and every layer you can identify the issues. In that way, only this APM tool is actually utilized. Say an example, I'll show a small picture. Maybe those who are working in performance testing, they can relate themselves in this activity, because I know I've been with these people. I worked as a performance tester. I know the pain and gain of working as a performance tester. Say an example, I am accessing this application, my organization application, through a browser. Say an example, I am accessing through a Chrome browser. Okay, all my requests are going to my physical server. Say in that physical server, there will be a web server, there will be an app server, and there will be a DB server. Okay, there will be a web server, there will be app server, and there will be a DB server. Okay, web server, app server, DB server. It is, you consider like a 3-tier or n-tier architecture also, whatever the case, you can consider it. Okay, so this is a little complex architecture, you think it like that. Okay, so I'm going to use a load runner, JMeter, NeoLoad, whatever kind of a tool, the performance testing tool that I'm going to work. What I'm going to do, I'm going to record my business flow. I'm going to record my business flow, right? Say like these tools are sitting in the middle. It is a man in the middle. Whatever may be the tool that you are using. Okay, you guys are using LoadRunner, you guys are using JMeter, you guys are using NeoLoad, whatever the tool that we are using. Okay, what will happen typically when we are doing your recording? What will happen typically? There is a request actually triggered from your browser. There is a request that is actually triggered from your browser. It will go via your tool. Okay, so what your tool will do, basically the tool will capture the request copy. Okay, it will say the copy of the request. It will take the copy of the request and it will send the request to your physical servers. Okay, so what will happen? Your request is reaching to your physical servers. In this forum, everybody knows this logic. Web server will have static content, app server will have business logic, DB server will have data. Web server will have static content, app server will have application logic, business flow, and then your DB server will have data. So all the things will be happening in your server and it will give back the response case. Okay, it will give back the response. So basically it will give back the response. This response will actually go via your tool. It will go via your tool basically. What will happen? The tool will capture the copy of the response also. The tool will capture the copy of the response and it will give back the response to the browser. Okay, while recording, this is what the thing is happening. A request is triggered, copy of the request is taken by the tool and it will give to the physical server. The physical server will do all the managing of the request and it will give back the response. The tool will copy the response and it will give back the response to the browser. This is what is typically happening in the browser when you are doing the recording, whichever the tool that you are using. Okay, recording completed. If I'm planning to do the replay of the script, what will happen, guys? What will happen? This entire layer is not there during the replay. Because the tool is actually captured the request. Right? The tool will try to hit the same copied request to the physical server. And the physical server will process the request and it will give back the response. What the tool will do, it is already copied one response. Currently, there is a response is coming. What the tool will do, it will compare the recorded response and the replay response and it will say the request is passed or failed. That is what is happening every time you are recording your transaction. Whenever you are recording your transaction, this is what is typically happening, guys. Now, in this forum will have a lot of performance testers. Anybody can say, in this entire explanation, what is actually missing, guys? There is a thing actually missing when we are representing our report to the customer. There is a key thing is actually missing. Anybody can say?
Exact client-side metrics, the metrics we usually get from Chrome DevTools and all those things. Yes.
Exactly, Sandeep. Wonderful answer. Exactly. The client side is actually totally missing. All your client side metrics is actually missing. Your client side metrics is nowhere. So what is happening whenever we are submitting this report to the customer? Most of the time, the customer is expecting a report which is having a client side metric, but our tool is not having the capability to do that. So that's where these APM tools are coming into the picture. In this forum, somebody can argue with me, somebody can discuss with me, somebody can say there is a protocol called a true client protocol that is actually giving you a client side response type.
Sarvan, just now I'm just trying to share the same thing with you. What are the things you have told right now? That is because only what HTTP protocol, because it's just executing in your socket layer. But in the same case, if you are going to use the true client protocol, that true client protocol is going to reply just like your QTP through browser. So that, but a lot of difficulty is that, I think you are also very familiar.
Yeah.
It is taking too much memory on that.
Wonderful, Arun. Yeah, that's where I'm coming to that point and you exactly replicated the same. True. So whenever people are saying true client protocol, so that true client protocol also, I would say, I know people in this forum are everybody too good in the protocols. this TrueClean protocol also will not have exactly replicate what is happening in the browser. Say like time to first byte, time to interactive, on load, full load, visually complete. All these things are actually happening in the true browser, your Chrome browser, right? So you are getting some metric which is inclusive of your client side response time. The TrueClean protocol will give you inclusive of the client side response time, but you cannot segregate what is client side, what is application layer, what is machine layer, what is your DB layer, what is happening in the analytics layer. Like that, you cannot segregate the things. Okay, so in that way, in that category, actually your AppDynamics tool is going to do a wonderful role. Your AppDynamics tool is going to give you a layer level report, tier level report, node level report. All those things are actually coming in your AppDynamics tool. So that is a wonderful key feature that is available in AppDynamics. That is one of the thing. And one more thing. Say an example. I am configuring certain things. Say like my response time should not go beyond that. My CPU utilization should not go beyond that. My memory utilization should not go beyond that. Like that, I'm configuring certain things. But AppDynamics tool, what it will do, you know, if something goes beyond that, there is a alerts and response options are there. Alerts and response is nothing but you can do a recovery action. You can do a recovery action. You can bounce back to the original status. You can restart your machine. You can do a thread dump. You can send a message to a stakeholder. You can send a mail to your stakeholder like that. There are intelligence that are available in AppDynamics. So what you can do, if there is a problem, there is a recovery. There is a problem, there is a recovery. So you can do that as well in your AppDynamics too. So what is happening? You can write your custom script to restart your machines. I'll clearly tell one example. How many of them in this forum, anytime did you observe a problem in Facebook? Anytime did you observe a problem in Facebook? Anybody?
No.
Anybody face a problem? Why they cannot actually saying I found a problem? That is the reason I'm asking this question. We will find a problem. Actually saying we can find a problem, but it will not prolong for even not even a 10 minutes. It will not prolong for not even 10 minutes. Not even 10 minutes they'll expect you to prolong that issue. What they are doing, you know, what these people are doing, this Facebook, Instagram, all those people, what they are doing, you know, they will have a 50 server, which is actually older stable code. They will have a current code in another 50 servers. Example, okay. Stable code in older 50 servers, current code in 50 servers. Say an example, if the current code is creating any kind of a problem, they'll have a switch. Straight away, they'll switch back to the older stable code, and you will not have to realize that there is a problem or what. That is how their deployment strategy, their architectural changes that they are maintaining. How those people are able to maintain these kind of a things? Because they are all having these kind of a APM tools. They are having all these kind of a profiling tools. They are having all these kind of a utility tools are built in. Analytic tool, APM tool, profiling tool, all these are built in their infrastructure. Quickly, it will identify all the issue and you can straight away bring back to the original status without having any problem. That is a wonderful thing that they are having. So that is where our organization, where we are working, right? Our organization also, if they are implementing these APM tools, it is really, really easy to bounce back to your original status without having any problem. Even I'll ask this question to you guys. Say an example, guys. You are doing a load test. How many of them are currently aware that the concurrent user that you are using or the throughput that you are using, it is exact replica of your production? How many of them are aware of in this forum? Nobody? Because it is all going in assumptions. It is all going in assumptions like what is happening to the concurrent user, what is happening to the throughput. Nobody aware of if it is an existing application. Don't think like it is for a new application. It is an existing application. Existing application only will have APM logs and all. So using this APM tool, you have a clarity. that how much of a throughput you are able to understand, how much of a user that are using your, like that you can easily identify this. So in that way also your EAPM tool is actually playing an important role. Okay, so I did a little explanation, so I'll take a pass here. Anybody have any question, please ask your question, guys. We'll discuss. Yeah, please.
Sir, like I have, like you said, we can avoid our response time, CPU and everything. Like for our application, we have Java ops, right? The memory tunables and all. If we set those, we can handle our response time in our limits, right? Like it will not, like giving an SLA instead, like you are saying AppDynamics give a recovery. In that case, we can give our Java ops, like survivor ratio will be some more thing, like we can control the memory tunables and everything, right? In that case, recovery will not be needed.
Yeah, true. Actually, I think you are little aware of the performance engineering things and all. Okay, I understand like that. Okay, say you know what is Eden, what is survivor ratio, what is new ratio, all those things are you are aware of, but it is not a generic set. In your team also, somebody would have unaware of those things also, possible, right? Possible.
Correct.
So tool that is designed in such a way that it should be a generic usable tool, Bhavana. Okay, so in that way only it is utilized. And one more thing also I'll tell you, it is not only the JVM related things, right? Whatever you mentioned, it is a JVM related things. Okay, think about if it is a C related things, it is a .NET related things, think about it is a Python related, PHP related, or else AWS related, Azure related, Alibaba related, Google Cloud related, Kubernetes related, containers related. Think about the wider range of technology stack, right? So in that case, making this configurable things possible, but it is time taking. Possible, it is time taking. So that is where this APM tool comes into a picture in a wider range. Did I answer your question, Bhavan?
Yes. And one more thing, like you have given an example of Facebook, right? There are n number of servers. If they have any issue with one server, they will shift to older version.
Yeah.
Correct. And like older version means if they will be having a trials, right, before entering to the new upgrade versions, they'll be trying everything, right? Then why the problem will arise, at what point of time they will have a recovery?
See, that one, say I'll tell you one thing. I just took one example of Facebook. It is not that we are trying to defame their thing. Okay, so actually Facebook, why I took is that, like, they never had the problem. That is the reason I took that example. And one more thing, all the way everybody in this world will do testing. Definitely they will do testing. But human is human. There will be definitely some kind of a problem will definitely come. It is not that I know there are people in this forum would be a functional testers also. If they are getting any new request to them, they will say, 100% I thoroughly tested the application, but who knows, in production it will create one another directly opposite way of issue. Okay, who knows, it will be bound to happen. So it is all parts and parcel of the day-to-day activity, but it tend to happen. But why I mentioned that example, there are recovery process, it is in place, and you can do that very easily. That is what I try to mention. And also it is need not be always, we don't want to always think about issue. But why I'm saying, if it is coming, how we can bounce back? Say an example, if Facebook down for 20 minutes, example I'm saying, will you accept it? Will you accept it, that 20 minutes of downtime? They will not accept it, right? They will not accept it. So that is a reason. They'll think like, I don't want to lose my credibility, reputation, my brand, like that. That is the reason people are investing too much of our money in doing these activities, maintaining the performance, maintaining these infrastructure things and all. Okay, that is the way it is. But I would say there, you can, if you ask me, even I will say 10 another different ways that I can avoid issue. if you are asking me, no, I will take 10 another different ways to avoid issue. But what I'm saying, these tools are designed in such a way that instead of spending that activity, it is a single source of truth wherein you can have a wonderful journey. That is what I'm trying to say now. Okay.
Okay. Okay, sir. Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, Bob. Thanks for your question, Bob. Yeah. Any further question, this? Thank you. So we'll move. So these are the topics that we are going to cover. Basically, we are going to have an understanding that what is APM tool, why performance tester should understand those APM tools, and then there is a two variety of AppDynamics is there. One is on-premises version, and another one is a SaaS version. We are going to have an understanding what is on-premises, what is SaaS model, those understanding, and then we are going to have there are agents are there. All these APM tools are working in the concept called agents. Okay, you need to have agents configured. Those agents will collect the data and it will send to the AppDynamics UI. That UI will take care of the data display. This is that UI. You can see this is a UI. You can see that I actually created some load just before our session. Okay. So if you could go and see the data, you can see there are wonderful information related to the application. What is your application? Is your application is a Java application, .NET application, PHP application, Python application? How many servers your application is having? How many servers are configured? If I go to the transaction level detail, say like whatever the transaction that are loaded, transaction level detail, if I want to capture like that, all the wonderful details we are going to get it. So in our learning, what I'm going to show you guys, for everyone, I'm going to share one Apache Tomcat server dump file. Okay, first of all, I will share you a Apache Tomcat server dump file. Okay, and I will show you how to deploy a application inside the Apache Tomcat server. I will show that practically. So what you guys can do, you can deploy that Apache Tomcat server in your machine, and I'm going to share one WAR file to you, everyone. WAR file. Okay, you can deploy that WAR file in that Apache Tomcat server, and then say why I'm doing that. You guys should realize, say in order to learn something, you need to have a sample application. Then only you can thoroughly learn something, right? Say an example, if you want to learn load runner means you need to have a sample application. You need to learn JMeter means you need to have a sample application. So for that, what I'm doing, I'm going to provide the dump file of Apache Tomcat server, and then I'm going to show you how to deploy the WAR file inside that Apache Tomcat server so that there is an application will be locally available for you. So whenever you are deploying the agents into it, you will learn thoroughly. So that is the reason. Also, I'm going to show you there is one more thing called Node.js server. Node.js. So I'm going to show you how to install a Node.js server and then how to deploy a Node.js application into that so that you can learn two things, guys. Okay. One is Apache Tomcat server. Another one is Node.js server. Two things we are going to learn with respect to the application agent. Okay. So we are going to learn what is application agent. Okay. Application agent. In that, I'm going to show you Apache Tomcat server one, and then I'm going to show you a Node.js application also. Okay, Node.js application also. And then we are going to learn machine agent. Okay, machine agent is nothing but your machine, say like your infrastructure, whether you deployed in Linux machine, Unix machine, whatever. Okay, that machine level CPU utilization, memory utilization metric you want to capture means that machine agent installation, configuration, data extraction, we are going to learn this. Okay. And then user experience agent. I just now mentioned, right? Your browser layer data is actually missing. That user experience agent also, I'm going to show you how to deploy it in your application, and then how your browser related data you are going to capture it. And then your database agent. Database agent also, we are going to learn MySQL database and then MongoDB database. two database we are going to learn. Okay, all in all, we are covering all the layer. We are covering the browser layer, machine layer, application layer, database layer, everything we are going to learn this. That is what we typically covered in this course content. Along with that, there is a alerting mechanism I told you, right? Alerting mechanism that I'm going to practically show you how to trigger a mail, how to take a thread dump. Basically, thread dump analysis we are going to learn, guys. Okay, thread dump analysis. Thread dump analysis we are going to learn. And we are also going to learn heap dump analysis. Okay, heap dump analysis and then thread dump analysis also we are going to learn. And then I'm going to show you how to create a dashboard, how to create a new report in AppDynamics, and how we are going to monitor that. After creating a dashboard, how we are going to monitor that. That also we are going to learn. And one another important concept called call graph. In AppDynamics, there is an important concept called call graph. We are going to learn that about in detail what is call graph. How am I going to identify my bottleneck? Which layer is a problem? Where exactly the time spent? All those things we are going to learn it using the call graph. And one more important thing we are going to do is that, like, there is a concept called REST API in AppDynamics. You can use a REST API. AppDynamics is exposing the data using the REST API, guys. Okay, you need to understand. Every tool vendor, you know, nowadays I'm saying, every tool vendor, they started exposing their data in the format of REST API. So in order to extract your AppDynamics data, you can use their REST API call also. You can use their REST API. I'm going to show you in Postman how you can use AppDynamics REST API to capture the data. That is what we are going to learn. And also one very important learning that we are going to, all the performance testers in this forum, we are going to get the benefit, like when we are running a test in LoadRunner or when we are running a test in JMeter, how that data is actually reflected in AppDynamics and how we are going to do the investigation. That we are going to learn. And there is an important concept called baselining. You can set the baseline. Actually, you can either you can set it or tool will also capture the baseline. Automatic baseline option is there. So how that is happening in Dynatrace? Say like last Monday what happened, this Monday what happened, last month what happened, this month what happened, last year what happened, this year what happened. That is called as your baselining concept. Okay, that is what we are going to learn. And also I'm going to share the tips and tricks in using the AppDynamics and real world example also I'm going to share it, and then question and answer. Basically, it is all whatever the clarification you everybody required, we'll be having a session to do the question and answer session. These are the different things that we are going to cover. Okay, there will be a documentation shared with everybody. Okay, post the session, a video will also be shared with everyone. The recorded video will be shared to everyone after the daily class session. Everybody will get the recorded video. Along with that, we'll also share the content. Along with that, I'll share the artifacts. Basically, the server, this WAR file, all those things also I will share post the session. Okay. Anybody have any question till now, guys? Anybody have any question?
Sarvan, Arun from this side.
Yeah.
I need to a small answer from you. As we heard about that agent and agentless, then through agent we are getting collecting the data, then the next responsibility of the UI, it is going to display our record, right?
Did you ask a question or?
I'm asking a question on that. Then we are going to get our data on our UI. But in case of agentless, then how it works and how we are going to get those data?
See, agentless is nothing but your instrumentation. Agent, you are going to have an agent sitting in your app server, web server, DB server, and you are doing the account. Agentless means inside your HTML page itself, you are going to instrument something. Okay, that is a agentless. But I don't know, agentless, agent, both are same only. Ultimately, it is up to the acceptance of the customer, how they are going to accept it. Whether they are going to accept, like I am going to instrument something in your HTML page, whether they will accept it or not, that is the decision from the customer itself. Okay. Based on the
Sarvan, I missed that on what exactly you just said. Can you repeat it, please?
Oh, you lost your audio, huh?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, I'll repeat it. Yeah, sure, definitely. Say agentless means, agent means something is installed in your infrastructure itself. App server, web server, DB server, that is actually doing the activity. Okay, but in agentless means, you are going to instrument something. In the HTML page itself, you are going to instrument something. Okay, that is say agentless monitoring. So most of the time, what will happen, a customer will not accept it to instrument something in their page itself. That will not that easily will happen, Arun. Okay.
Okay.
It is up to the acceptance of the customer whether I'm going to allow or I'm not going to allow. If I'm going to allow,
right.
If I'm not going to allow, the agent that is going to install in the infrastructure, right? At least you can tell to the customer it is not going to touch your source code. It is a wrapper around your source code. That way you can convince the customer. But this instrumentation, you cannot even convince the customer because most of the customer, this banking customer or the insurance customer, what they will think, you are going to take their data. You are going to take their data. So they will not accept that one. So it is up to the mindset of the people whether you are going to have instrumented code or agent installed. That is completely up to you. You are getting my point, Arun?
Yes, okay.
Yeah, that is still open. I mean, we are getting
thank you. Yeah, thank you. Thanks for your question. Thanks for your valuable question. Any question? Somebody pinged in the message.
Sarvan and Pawan here.
Yeah, Pawan.
What is the difference between AppDynamics and Dynatrace?
We cannot straight away say a difference, but both are good APM tools in the industry. Very few things are actually. Little difference will be there for both of the tools. Okay, actually these guys, the Dynatrace, they are saying like everything one agent. But here AppDynamics is having a concept called universal agent, but they are not promoting. In AppDynamics documentation, if you go and read it, you know, they'll say universal agent, but they are not promoting. And here there is a concept called smartscape topology in Dynatrace. Here in AppDynamics, that is called as flow map. Here in Dynatrace, it is called a spear path. Here it is called as call graph. Here also they are having dashboard. In AppDynamics also they are having dashboard. Like that, everybody is having their own unique feature, but slightly difference in the way they are representing. Other than that, quite a similar feature will be there, Pawan.
Oh, okay. For the user experience, which one will be the better among the two?
Actually, user experience agent is available in AppDynamics. In Dynatrace, it is called as real user monitoring. RUM.
My question was for user experience. Between the two, which is very good for users?
Both are good only, but I would say these both tools are working in an agile model. Okay, both are working in agile model. The way the latest release is with Dynatrace, they looks to be good. Maybe because they released the latest one, right? They released the one agent of 2.1 version. Okay, maybe because of that, they are little recent one. Other than that, both are good in the way they are representing. Maybe this guy in the upcoming week, AppDynamics is releasing something new, means they will be looking good. That is how always a healthy competition is going between AppDynamics and Dynatrace. Yeah. Thank you, Pawan. Thanks for your question.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
Hello, Sidhu here. I just want to know what is the difference between Glowroot and the AppDynamics.
What is it?
Glowroot and AppDynamics, because previously we used to Glowroot.
See, so apologies for this. I'm little new to this term Glowroot. Okay.
Glowroot.
But what is it?
It is also an APM tool. Glowroot.
Yeah, maybe budding APM tool or what? I don't know. But AppDynamics and Dynatrace, market share is very, very high. Okay. Largely people are using that AppDynamics and Dynatrace. this Glowroot that you are saying, right? How many agent support is there for Glowroot?
I think it's one, I guess.
One. Yeah, maybe because of that. There is only one agent. But if you go to these tools, whatever I'm saying, right? This AppDynamics and all, you have the n number of agent support is there. Everything will be monitored and then supported. That is how they are leading the market. They are leading the market.
Okay. And one more question, like for DB monitoring, can you explain for MS SQL as well? Because as in a topic mentioned, is only for MS MySQL. So we are using MS SQL.
Yeah, explaining is okay, but thing is, we are not getting the infrastructure for MS server. That is the reason we did not having that. You could have understand whatever the tool that I use, it is an open source tool, right? You can easily get it. This whatever you are saying is a licensed one, right? The spending will be very high. See, I'll tell you, procedurally everything is same. I'll tell you this practically. Procedurally everything will be same. In order to learn something, why do we want to spend a lot of money in learning that? That's the reason. That is the reason behind.
Okay.
Anyways, the procedure I'm going to share with you, right? The same procedure you can implement it for the MS DB also. Okay. So you can definitely use that. You can definitely use it. Only thing, we don't want to spend a lot of licensing for learning that, which means that our learning cost also will be increasing, right? That is a reason. Okay, Sito?
Okay, thank you.
Yeah, thank you. Thanks a lot. Yeah. So if you do not have further question, what will I do? I'll show you a sample. Say like I am going to purposefully run a test. Okay, so this and all during our course journey I will explain in detail, guys. Don't worry that what I am doing now. For now, for the benefit of everyone, what is the real capability of AppDynamics, right? That is the reason I'm showing this. What I'm going to do, like a performance tester, I'm going to be like a performance tester. I am going to run a test which will hit my physical server. That physical server will be struggling, and then it is going to throw some error. How am I going to investigate through AppDynamics? That is what I am going to show you guys. Okay, so I already prepared one script for my application. Okay, what I am going to do, I am going to hit my application with the heavy load. Okay, heavy load, I'm going to hit my application. What will happen? It will hit my physical server. That traffic will be exactly captured in AppDynamics. And how am I going to investigate the issue? That I'm going to show you guys. Okay. Within very few minutes, within 1 or 2 minutes, the tool will actually capture the data. We'll see that. Last 5 minutes traffic, I'll capture it. Two notifications started coming. It is saying there is a data started. Notification is saying data started coming. We'll see within how much time it is able to populate the value. It is saying currently all the traffic that is coming inside is actually healthy. It is saying it is all in green color. Everything is healthy now. We'll see that within some time what is happening. You can see heavy load is actually triggered to my application. That is actually going. Yeah, see, we can start heavy traffic is coming inside the application. The application started getting the data within very few minutes. You can see that is actually started coming. You can see errors are also started coming. 95 errors, slow transactions started coming. Everything is started coming. So every load is pumping in now. The log is actually printing inside the application now. So I just now I mentioned the wonderful feature that is available, right? What I can do straight away, I can double click this transaction and then see like what is really happening to that application. Why is that actually showing some, I can observe it here. It is trying to put a graph. Basically, it is trying to put a graph like what is happening. You can see it is creating a flow map. That is the intelligence of this AppDynamics tool. You can see there is application request is actually going to the database, HSQL database. There is a request is going. Did I do any configuration? No, I did not do any configuration. AppDynamics is having the intelligence to automatically detect that, and it is saying the request is going from your Java application to the database, and it is saying there are slow transactions, slow or very slow transaction. What I'm doing, I'm clicking the very slow transaction. Very slow transaction. What is that very slow transaction I'm checking now? And it is saying there are application, it is taking some 757 milliseconds, which is actually less only, but in this case it is looks to be high. So what I'm doing, I'm double clicking it and then going to the investigation page. I'm seeing like there is a drill down option, and I can click on the drill down option. So it is saying which place the actual time spent, that 100% time spent where in this servlet call only 100% of the time it spent. So you're exactly getting the issue. You can click and see the details of it. You can click and see the detail of that particular servlet call. The tool is actually giving you to the exact place. You can see it is saying this name, this type, this class name, this method name, this line number, it is actually having the problem. It is exactly going to the point where the issue is there. So your job's little easy when you are doing this installation of this AppDynamics APM tool base. Okay, this is just a sample that I showed you. When we are going for our learning, we are going to learn about application agent, we are going to learn about machine agent, we are going to learn about database agent, we are going to learn about user experience agent. All those learning we are going to do, guys. Okay, anybody have any question till now? Yeah, thank you. So guys, those who are interested to proceed further, what you can do, I'm pasting this link in our chat now. You guys can directly go to that link. You can go to the link and then you can enroll yourself, or you can use this number, which is Kumar sir number, for further details related to the class timing is same time, 8 to 9 Indian time and 10:30 to 11:30 US time. You guys can reach out to Kumar sir for further information. You can reach out to Kumar sir. This is a number, 8019952427 is a number. You can reach out to Kumar sir for further information. Those who are not part of our group, actually we are having a group running, right? Those who are not part of our group, you know, please put your WhatsApp number here, so that I can add your number in the group itself, so that further communication will be reaching it to you. Or you can put your mail ID so that I can pass it on to the Isha Training Solution, so that they can send all the information to you guys. Okay, it is weekdays only, Zahid, it is weekdays only, Monday to Friday. Weekdays we are going to have this session by 8 to 9 Indian time and then 10:30 to 11:30 Eastern time. So we are going to have weekday session learning only. Please those who are interested, please reach out to Kumar sir, 8019952427. Based on the registration and then the payment progress, we'll start our session. Probably by tomorrow, we'll start our session. So please go to Kumar sir. This is our link. You can see all the course content. That is the reason I shared that link to you guys. You can check your course content. If you have any question related to the course content, please reach out to me. My number also, I'll paste it here. 9790790293. This is my number. I am Saravanan Srinivasan. You can reach out to me for any clarification questions. You can reach out to me. Please reach out to Kumar sir also for the further detail. For the day one session, probably tomorrow will be the day one session. If you want to get the information related to the day one session, please reach out to Kumar sir. His number is this one. Thanks everyone. Thanks for giving me this opportunity, giving Isha Training Solution for this opportunity to share our knowledge in AppDynamics. We'll all group together, we'll all learn together the AppDynamics tool. Thanks everyone once again for giving this opportunity. Thanks all. Bye bye.
Thanks Arun.
Thanks Arun. Thanks all. Thank you Arun for your question. Thanks Siddhu. Thanks for your question. Thanks everyone. Thanks Bhavana for your question. Thanks Pavan for your question.
Thank you, Sharwana. Thank you.
Thanks, Jagdish.